Joining us now, Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross. I love, you know, speeches for what they're worth, Wilbur, but I really want to look ahead and figure out what you can tell us about some upcoming stuff in terms of NAFTA, for example, and in terms of whether there really is going to be another attempt at some multilateral stuff that we heard about last week with TPP. Behind the scenes, and also what, you know, the next step with China. We had solar panels and washing machines, but can you address all three of those? Where are we on NAFTA? Will we try to get in TPP now that it's already moving forward? Was that real or just a sort of a trial balloon? What do you know?
Well, NAFTA just is concluding its sixth series of talks. The ones up in Montreal just got finished. They've made some progress again on the easy issues. Very little has been done on the hard issues. But there is another round that'll be in another several weeks. So we remain optimistic that there could be some progress made. But it is far from being completed at this point.
So you can't assign any type of probability. I would think, you know, I saw another piece yesterday, the day before, in the Wall Street Journal. An author wrote that NAFTA is responsible for our 0.5% GDP every year. And if we get rid of it, it's just going to make it more difficult. In your view, is the president still negotiating by holding out the possibility of exiting it completely, or is that a real possibility?
Well, it's definitely a possibility. It's hard to debate whether the deal, as it will be finally presented to the president, is good or bad when the major features of it have yet to be concluded.
Okay.
So it'll either be 100% or 0%. It won't be some percent in between.
What would be the next step to talk to the parties involved in TPP to say we'd like to consider joining it? Will you take that step?
Well, the president announced in Davos that if TPP is modified from where it had been, he would consider joining it, the modified TPP. But remember, they don't have their act together among themselves. The so-called group of 11 is not completely resolved on its own, let alone resolved relative to what concessions they might make to the United States. So it's a little bit early to judge that one as well.
Well, what goes on? What would be the next thing the Trump administration would do now that you flow the trial balloon to actually take a concrete step towards re-engaging on that? What would you do that? Would a trade rep do it? How would that happen, and is it going to happen?
Well, the president made clear that he needs some further conditions before he would want to enter into it. But right now, the big occupation is with NAFTA, because that's the one that's really underway. And as I mentioned, in terms of TPP, they haven't resolved all the issues among themselves, so it's a little bit premature.
So and then the third thing I was talking about was China. What will be the next thing we hear? Will it be China retaliating? Will there be something in addition to solar? Is steel next? You know a lot about steel, obviously, being involved with so many turnarounds there. What do you think the next chapter on the whole China situation is with tariffs?
Well, there are three chapters. You have the 301 investigation about intellectual property rights. You have the 232 on steel. You have the 232 on aluminum. And then you have a whole host of more routine trade cases that come up every week or two. In the last year, we did more than 80 initiated trade actions, which was up more than 50% from a year ago, largely because there are more infractions being committed by other parties.
All right, so you can't predict the future, I guess. You don't know what the next shoe to drop is going to be, and whether it's from China or whether it's from from the United States.
Well, the president has made it very clear that his policy is to strictly enforce trade agreements. And that's importantly a job for the Commerce Department to do. And we will continue to do that, and we will continue to self-initiate cases. But his speech last night was about a lot more than just trade. I thought it was a very uplifting, very empathetic, very exciting speech. And in fact, after the 100th time that we stood up and applauded, I stopped counting. It's remarkable to have 100 times in a speech where everybody, with a few exceptions, stands up and applauds. So it's a great testimonial to the president, as is the rising stock market so far this morning.
Yep, that there's going to be a rebound. Obviously this morning, the 2.6 on the fourth quarter. It depends on what, like so many things. It's like a Rorschach test for people, because it would have been, you know, if we were averaging 1.5 to 2, and then all of a sudden you get a couple of threes, and then you get a 2.6. You would think maybe that's the low end of the current environment, but that's not the way people. I saw certain outlets just say that was a disastrous quarter at 2.6. The first quarter,
2.6 was better than most quarters, right, that we've seen for years and years.
There's a problem with the first quarter. There has been, and Leisman's done a lot of work on this, and you've seen it. There's some weird inventory build that goes on, and the first quarter has typically, in the last 3, 4, 5 years, has always been the lowest of the year. So that's something to consider this time around, I think.
Well, sure, because you have the post-Christmas thing as well. That's a very big complicating factor.
So what would be what's your forecast, and what would you be satisfied with for the first quarter? And will it average out to, will there be, I don't know what we'd need to get an actual 3% year, but the naysayers, until you get an average for four quarters of 3%, they're going to say that none of this is working.
Well, remember, the naysayers were, before President Trump's election, they were saying we'd never get over a 1.5 to 2%. So they've already been proven quite wrong. And remember, this year, the tax bonuses just are being paid. Almost 3 million Americans are getting a $1,000 or more check. And while Nancy Pelosi may scoff at that, that just shows how out of touch she is with the importance of a $1,000 check to the average working person. In addition, it won't be until February that the withholding goes down. So the first quarter is going to be a transitional quarter in very many regards. But it's quite clear the direction. I mean, who would have thought a year ago, 6 months ago, or even 3 months ago, that almost 3 million Americans would get checks from their employers specifically share the tax bill.
Wilbur, I'm looking at President's Twitter feed, and it's quiet, too quiet. I always wanted to say that. There's 11 hours since the last one, so I'm gonna stay here, expecting I'll get back to you. It could be any second here, but what's going on?
It's almost ADP.
He might be sleeping in. But I like it.
Mr. Secretary.
I like it when it happened. Anyway, but we appreciate it. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
He had so much good things to say last night.
He did.
Hey there. Thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.